Jurassic Park 3. What a movie. What a production. What a smorgasbord of disappointment and mediocrity. What a letdown. What an embarrassment to see our hero, Alan Grant, do the one thing he said he'd never do again for something as superficial as money. The exact reason he was on the first island to begin with. Oh dear. Oh dear. However, despite all of its flaws, when I was growing up, I still loved watching Jurassic Park 3. Perhaps it was just a sense of nostalgia from the first movies that drew me in. Or perhaps it was because I was a dumb kid and bought into the marketing campaign. Or maybe it was the still excellent Stan Winston brand practical effects. Boy, do I wish they still made movies like that. But no, I think the main reason I was watching it was because it introduced me to one of my favorite dinosaurs. A dinosaur even bigger than T-Rex. The latest Jurassic World might want you to think Giganotosaurus holds the crown for biggest theropod murder machine, but that movie is wrong. And stupid. I don't want locusts in my dinosaur movie! Get them out of here! Today we talk about the real reason I used to love watching Jurassic Park 3. The real biggest boy of the meat-eating dinosaur world. And that biggest boy is... Hello and welcome. I am Second Voltage, and this is Paleo Corner, a series where I make some paleo art, and we learn about the fascinating creatures of prehistory along the way. This time, we go back 90 million years ago to the Cretaceous period and explore perhaps one of the most controversial and divisive dinosaurs in paleontology, Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus aegypticus is the correct Latin title of this animal, and it means spined lizard from Egypt. It was named for its iconic sail along its dorsal vertebrae. Discovered in 1912 in Egypt by German paleontologist Ernst Strummer, and was first named and described by Strummer in 1915, the holotype specimen was widely incomplete. Yet it was still more complete than most of the specimens we have found more recently. As a result, we know comparatively little about Spinosaurus due to the lack of specimens. This has given rise to much speculation and widely different theories and opinions in the scientific community about how this animal looked and behaved. The original remains contained the most complete example of its iconic sail, and perhaps much more could have been learned from them with modern techniques. Unfortunately, Spinosaurus has doubly bad luck. Not only did it go extinct in the prehistoric era, but for a while it was extinct in the modern era too, as the original remains were destroyed quite violently in a bombing raid during World War II in 1944 by the British Royal Air Force. Thankfully, newer material has been discovered in the 21st century. Some of the most recent discoveries revealing astonishing new information and has significantly changed the way we view this animal today. There has been much debate over the years as to the exact size and shape of Spinosaurus. Some estimates put it as long as 18 meters, but the most recent estimates put it somewhere in the range of 13 to 15 meters long and 2.5 meters tall from the hip. The average estimates for the weight put it at around 6.5 to 7.5 metric tons. Spinosaurus were among the largest of carnivorous theropod dinosaurs, estimates putting it at around a similar size or even bigger than other giant predators such as T-Rex, Giganotosaurus, and Carcharodontosaurus. Though whilst it's bigger in numbers, certainly bigger in length than these alpha predators, Spinosaurus was far slimmer and more lean than these other dinosaurs. And whilst Spinosaurus may have technically been taller than T-Rex if measured by the sail, or its head being fully extended, if the two were side by side in real life, it certainly wouldn't be towering over the king of the dinosaurs, like the opposing monster we see in Jurassic Park. Its sail is also a matter for debate. Since there has only been a single complete vertebrae found, we cannot be sure on its exact shape. Some paleo artists depicted round, whilst others depicted more square with a dip in the middle. Additionally, we cannot be certain of the functionality of the sail either. There have been a number of varied hypotheses over the years, including display and heat regulation. The sail was rather prominent and could simply have served to make the animal look larger and more intimidating than it really was, especially when it had other large theropods to contend with. Wait a minute, Spinosaurus, I thought you were supposed to be the biggest boy! Now I learn you've been faking it this whole time! Shame! Shame on you!
Hey, that's it! Dishonor! Dishonor on your whole family! Make a note of this! Dishonor on you! Dishonor on your cow!
Like absolutely everything about Spinosaurus, its diet is highly debated too. It is generally assumed it ate fish, as its conical teeth and long snout are indeed suited to catching that kind of prey, as well as other closely related dinosaurs having been found with fish in their stomachs. Some argue that it is a highly specialized piscivore and ate almost entirely fish, but others argue it was more of a predatory generalist, and there is evidence for this also. Baryonyx, a similar dinosaur, was found not only with fish amongst its stomach contents, but parts of a iguanodon as well, which is evidence that itself was a generalist, preying on fish and larger land-dwelling prey alike. Spinosaurus, being a similar type of animal, may have acted the same. Another spinosaur, it was discovered with the remains of a large pterosaur in its stomach. And another spinosaurid, Samosaurus, was found to have even eaten sauropods, the biggest prey of all. If Spinosaurus behaved anything like its contemporaries, it was certainly a generalist then. But there is ample evidence also that it is adapted for eating fish, and spent at least some of its time in the water. So the exact nature of its diet still remains a mystery. Spinosaurus lived 99 to 93.5 million years ago in what is now northern Africa. The environment it inhabited is only partially understood and covers a good deal of Morocco, Libya, Tunisia, and Egypt. The Spinosaurus who lived around the Bahariya Formation in Egypt may have found themselves dealing with shoreline conditions and channels rather than the coast, and large tidal flats. They may have lived in forests populated with mangroves and lived alongside other large predators like Bahariasaurus and Carcharodontosaurus, and titanosaur sauropods such as Egyptosaurus and Paralelititan, one of which I have included in the background of my artwork. Crocodilomorphs, bony and cartilaginous fish, turtles, lizards, and plesiosaurs may have also been present. Like modern Africa, there would have been a dry season, and perhaps this was a period where Spinosaurus may have resorted to trickier prey like pterosaurs. Possibly the biggest debate of all surrounding Spinosaurus is whether or not it spent its time on land or in the water. The first thesis is largely based on the fossil discoveries in 2014 and specimens recovered in 2018, which revealed that Spinosaurus had elongated neural spines along both sides of its tail, as well as sufficient density to allow it to use its tail to easily propel itself through water. I think the tail bears a resemblance to the body and the tail of a monitor eel, a highly adapted aquatic predator, so this thesis clearly has logic behind it. On the other hand, there is also a counter-thesis based around conductive research that refutes the semi-aquatic thesis for Spinosaurus. This research studied the buoyancy in the lungs of crocodilians, and compared it to that of Spinosaurus. Using this data, they concluded Spinosaurus would not have the capacity to sink or dive below the surface of the water. It also concluded that in order to stay upright, it would need to constantly paddle its hind legs. Research by Lauder and Pierce also led to the discovery that Spinosaurus's tail had 8 times the forward thrust of other tails of terrestrial theropods. So it would seem the tail, at least, was adapted to life in water, and perhaps Spinosaurus had behavior similar to modern crocodiles, spending a lot of their time in the water. A more recent study in 2022 found that Spinosaurus had bones similar to those of penguins, which are specifically adapted for diving. Which is counter-evidence to the buoyancy research that claims that Spinosaurus is incapable of such behavior. Though, there are further counter-arguments to this, as penguins require physical exertion from their wings in order to dive and stay underwater. The equivalent effort required for this same behavior from Spinosaurus would be massive as a result of its large size, which leads diving behavior to again seem unlikely. Another paper suggests that Spinosaurus perhaps instead behaved more like modern wading birds, such as storks. There are numerous papers, studies, and research throwing evidence and theories to either side of this debate. Until further evidence or new fossils come to light, it's unlikely we'll have an answer to this question anytime soon. In any case, it's clear the animal we are comprehending here is very different from the one on Jurassic Park 3, at least. Some more of the inconsistencies in that creature's design include the general body proportions, especially the legs, which are far too long. The tail is too small in relation to the body. And of course, the tail does not have the elongated neural spines that give it its distinctive shape. Though the crew of Jurassic Park 3 can hardly be blamed for that last one, since this was yet to be discovered at the time. But as amazing as the Stan Winston animatronic is, it still looks too oversized and misproportioned to truly be Spinosaurus. Steven Spielberg, you have betrayed me again! There I was as a kid, believing Spinosaurus was a ginormous predatory monster of an animal. Now I learn it had a skinny swimmer's bod and a fish fetish. But that aside, here is my finished artwork. You can see here with a rough, vaguely humanoid purple shape for size comparison. I perhaps shrink-wrapped the arms a bit too much, but hell, if Spinosaurus did spend a lot of time swimming, perhaps it did also have low body fat. Or perhaps it had massive blubber like a seal and tiny little body hairs. Who knows? Nobody right now, that's for sure. To illustrate how widely we can speculate with this animal, I also made this speculative version with a neck frill for display and feathery quills. We know other theropods had feathers. Why not this one too? Personally, I think it's unlikely that Spinosaurus did have feathers due to its likely attraction to the water, though we have plenty of modern water birds that I'm sure would want to disagree with me on that. Judging by the shape of its head, I'd say it's more likely it was more crocodilian in appearance. But that's the thing with Spinosaurus, we just don't know. Hopefully someday soon we'll find a more complete specimen that will shed some light on all of these unanswered questions. I also drew it with a fish in its mouth, but since I don't know many prehistoric fish, I basically just drew a big coelacanth. This is probably not the most accurate, but I'm not an ichthyologist, so whatever. I don't know what fish is, what fish do, what fish be, what is fish, me not know. In any case, despite the debacle of Jurassic Park 3, the recent discoveries of Spinosaurus specimens, and the new way we depict this animal, I still think it's really cool. One of my favorites, in fact. I think I like it even more this way compared to in the movies. Jurassic Park 3 Spinosaurus felt like a great movie monster, but the new depictions of Spinosaurus feel like a real animal. And with that, I feel like there's only one thing left to say. Please, stop making these god-awful Jurassic World movies. I mean, the first one was okay, but the other two... Just stop it! Stop! Stop! Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more content like it, please like and subscribe.
Do it.